Welcome to the voice of the Lord. Our verse for today is in Matthew chapter 5, verse 20. For I tell you that unless your righteousness surpasses that of the Pharisees and the teachers of the law, you will certainly not enter the kingdom of heaven. This is a warning coming from the Lord Jesus. He said that we got to surpass the righteousness of the Pharisees. Otherwise, we cannot enter heaven. But what's wrong with the Pharisees and the teachers of the law? Friends, they are really good. You know, they can memorize the law and they try to observe it. But in their observance, it is only outward. See, they go by the letter of the law and not by the spirit of the law. There is so much hypocrisy. They just observe it outwardly so that men will see that they are good. They will pray at the street corners. See, they do good works in front of people. But inside, friends, they are full. Jesus said that they are full of murmuring and complaining. There is no love inside. No. It is just for men to see. That's why in Matthew 23, he called them as hypocrites, like whitewashed tomb. See, a tomb, friends, where dead men are kept. He said that you are like a whitewashed tomb. From the outside, it's beautiful, but inside, it's full of rotten bones. And that's how Jesus described the Pharisees, and we should not be like them, he said. You got to surpass them. So in surpassing them, then we got to obey the letter of the law and the spirit of the law. Amen? It is not just the letter of the law. No, including the spirit of the law. What does the Lord want us really to do? When he said that love your neighbor, then we love them not outwardly, just to show men, just for show. No, love them with all your heart. Amen? There has to be more sacrifices. There are sacrifices, yes, in loving others. And he wants us to do that. So it's not just for men to see. You see, if you give to your neighbor, don't announce it. Say, oh, see, I'm helping my neighbor. No. Even in giving, friends, he said, do it secretly. So that, again, it's from your heart. That's how we surpass the righteousness of the Pharisees and the teachers of the law. They are good. Well, friends, you cannot deny that they can memorize scriptures. They can teach the scripture. They are expert in teachings, friends. The teachers of the law, they are really good. But the problem here is they don't apply it themselves. It's in the application that they were lacking. And so let's pray, friends, that as we study scripture, we are not just hearer or student of the scripture. Let us be doer of the scripture. Let us apply it in our lives. Amen. Let's apply not based on the letter of the law, but based on the spirit of the law. So this is how the Lord wants us to live our lives, friends. Let us live with sincere heart. Let's encourage one another, friends, not because it's a ministry that God had given us, but it is because we love them. Amen. And so I pray that today, again, learn something out of what we discussed today. Let us not be hypocrite. Rather, let us be sincere to one another. Amen. See, hypocrisy, it can be shown. You know why? Because Jesus said that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Yes, you can do good outwardly, and they will praise you for what you're doing outwardly, because everything is good, perfect outside. But you know what? If you are harboring all kinds of bitterness within, one day this will come out, because the mouth speaks what is in your heart. It's not a slip of the tongue. No. People say that, oh, I'm sorry, it's just a slip of the tongue. No. That is the abundance of the heart. You are keeping rotten bones inside. Amen. You are rotten inside. What Jesus said, that's what Jesus said to the Pharisees. You are rotten inside, and this will come out. So I pray, friends, that let us consider again the way that we live our lives. Let us surpass the righteousness of the Pharisees then we can enter heaven. Amen. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May His face shine upon each one of you and be gracious unto you, and lift up His countenance on you and give you His Shalom. Amen. God bless, and see you again next time. Bye.